Put it sweetly. To hell with you! That's right, to hell with you! From now on, it's gonna be me, Rosie, on the town, singing, dancing, having a ball, making up for 8 years of being in love with an aspirin splitting, mama clutching, 5'7" tower of jello! What did I ever see in him? How could I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that I'm safely on the ground again, now that my senses have been found again, what did I ever see in him? Is he tender? No, he's not. Is he thoughtful? No, he's not. Am I crazy? What's he got that I found so damned appealing? What did he ever do for me? Well, to be honest, he was sometimes nice, but still it wasn't worth the awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart. How did I ever, why did I ever, what did I ever? Don't be upset, Miss Alvarez. All men can't be like that. Every one of them. Except maybe Albert Schweitzer. And I'm not his type. They're all the same. From puberty to senility, from Benedict Arnold to Mussolini.
Oh, well, I never understood why Ingrid Bergman married him in the first place.
Egotistical, selfish human beasts.
Well, then what are we poor women to do, Miss Alvarez?
Use them. Let them be our playthings while we live. Sip from the cup of life. Mix the potion full strong and drain it to the dregs. How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't. Will we leave them? No, we won't. Tell me, what did I say that for? What did we ever see in them? How could we ever think that they were nice? Take it from us, we paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken days, broken nails, broken hearts. What did we ever see in them?
Hugo S. Peabody.
Huh?
Hugo. What did I ever see in him? He's as bad as Mr. Peterson, if not worse. Miss Alvarez, I'm coming with you.
Kim, don't be ridiculous. You're only 16.
Juliet was 14 when she left home.
And look what happened to her. Now look, why don't you have some milk and cookies and go to bed?
It's too late for cookies, Miss Alvarez. I want to live. We'll sip the drinks together. We'll help each other with a... Miss Alvarez?
Look, Albert, for the last time, I'm okay, and I don't feel like getting into bed. Now leave me alone.
Now look here, Conrad. You had a severe shock, and the best thing for you to do is to get upstairs and get some... Aha! There she is. The traitor that stabbed me in the heart when my back was turned.
Get out of my way, Albert.
Be careful, Sonny. She may be armed.
I can handle her, Mama. You go upstairs with Conrad and make sure he gets into bed.
Conrad, wait for me. I'll make you a nice hot cup of terriomycin.
For the last time, Albert, will you let me by?
Not! So I've had my say, Rosie. I just want to let you know that thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all. Tomorrow morning at the station before Conrad leaves. So, looks like you failed, Rosie. As anyone must fail who tries to buck Al Peterson, one of the giants, the titans, the King Kongs of the music industry.
What did I ever see in him? How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts.
An empire builder, a colossus.
Get out of my way, you defrocked English teacher. What did I ever see in him?
Rosie, come back here, Rosie. Do you hear me? This is King Kong calling. Rosie! Rosie! I need you. Rosie. And I don't care how you plead and beg, Miss Alvarez. Not only do I accept your resignation, but you're fired. And one more thing. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but names will never hurt me, you big rat. Sorry to do this in front of you folks, but I had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that. Probably Hong Kong again. Hello, this is Albert Peterson speaking. Sorry, Miss Alvarez is no longer with us. That's right.
Miss Alvarez, wait for me! I'm coming with you!
Where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie, to drain deep the dregs and sip foolhardy the brimming cup to live.
Upstairs.
Daddy.
Upstairs. Do you hear me? I said upstairs.
Miss Alvarez was right. You men are all the same, from puberty to Mussolini.
What's that? You dare say puberty in front of your own father? Not to mention Mussolini. Doris, we failed as parents. I never asked for much from my children. Just respect, a little respect. That's all I asked for. But did I get respect? I did not get respect. I got no respect.
I respect you, Paul.
I don't want your respect. You're a child. What good is respect from a child? Doris, take me upstairs. I'm not a well man. Certain words I didn't want to hear in this house. Puberty was one, and Mussolini was another. Now look here, Mr. Lewis. No 3-cent reporter can bulldoze me. This is Albert J. Peterson you're speaking to. And you can print that in whatever cheap newspaper you represent. Oh, it's not a newspaper. It's a magazine. And it's not Mr. Lewis. It's Mr. Lewis. Life magazine. Oh, Rosie, I need you.
Sonny boy, where are you going?
Nowhere, Mama. Just out. It was getting stuffy in here, and I thought I'd... To look for Rosie, Mama. I love her, and I want her back.
Is that all? I thought it was something serious. By all means, Sonny, find your lady of Spain and bring her back here. And on your way back, be sure to stop in the kitchen, take my head out of the oven, and turn off the gas.
Mama, it's electric.
It's a strange house. I don't want to run up a bill.
Mama, I'm tired of this nonsense. If you really love me, you'd help me find Rosie. Don't you understand what's happened? She's gone out to make up for all the years she's wasted on me. Who knows what low dive she could be in at this very moment?
You're right, Sonny. I'll help you find her. Only, maybe I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Nothing to worry about, sweetheart, darling. He just said he's going out tonight, and he doesn't think he'll be back in time to kiss Kid tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me this before?
I tried to, sweetheart, darling, but you kept bringing up a certain party from south of the border.
How could he do this to me? He knows how much this means to me. Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, Albert. I'm coming. Before you start hollering, I just want you to know, I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 in the morning, having people watch me when I eat, letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, have some fun. Did you get it, Albert? I am tense.
Mama, don't just stand there, do something.
Conrad, did you ever think in terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense. Now look here, buddy boy. It's my last free night before I go to the Army, and I'm going out.
You can't go out without my permission. It says so in your contract. Mama, give my contract. It's in my... Oh, never mind, I'll get it myself. You, stay right there.
Conrad.
There are chicks just right for some kissing, and I mean to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks don't know what they're missing. I've got a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks all ready for tasting. And there's Cadillacs, all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is a-wasting. There's such a lot of living to do. To see everything for you and me. Hey, you kids live here, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Birdie.
What's the lowdown on this town?
Great Apple, Ohio was founded in 1852 by Jeremiah S. Appleby.
No, I mean, what do you do here? You go to have a ball.
Well, there's the church basement and the sweet shop and the old
Kiskunyanka.
What's there?
I don't know. Ice, I guess.
It just so happens, Mr. Birdie, the ice house is where people go when they want to be alone.
Isn't she that chick I was supposed to kiss?
I am not a chick. I'm a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm leaving home.
Now you're talking chick. Come on, let's move. We've got things to do.
Crazy clothes and motorboat races.
Someone nice.
Gotta love to you. Broadway lights and wide open spaces. There's such a lot of living to do. There's a place to know what's in store for you. You have a blue and love at the view.
and me.
Swims and motorboat races and loop the loop. I'm gonna do the only sensible thing. Drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims, motorboat races, loop the loop.
Excuse me. Mr. McAfee, you haven't seen Conrad, have you?
No, but I intend seeing him, Mr. Peterson. So if you have a message, I'll deliver it right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? Oh, I'm gonna find Rosie.
Doris, get my gun.
No, dear, what are you talking about? You know you don't have a gun.
There's that Daisy air rifle in the garage.
That's my fault.
Oh, you shut up. I wonder where I can find babies this late at night.
Anyway, it's broken, dear.
Well, then get me anything. There's that bow and arrow with the suction tips that I bought you last Christmas. Don't just stand there. My daughter's run off the loop with a fiend. Get me a water gun. Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids who can understand anything they say. Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers. And while we're on the subject, you can talk and talk till your face is blue. Kids, yet they still do just what they want to do. Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids today? Kids! I don't mind the moonlight swims. It's the loop that hurts. Kids! Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11? Kids! I didn't know what puberty was till I was almost past it. They are just impossible to control. Kids with their awful clothes and their rock and roll. Why can't they dance like we did? What's wrong with Sammy K?
Hey, Pop, here's my pea shooter.
A pea shooter? What good's it? Give it to me. What's the matter with kids today?
I'll have a double rocks on the scotch. And put some rocks in it this time. Can you make me a vodka malted?
How old are you?
32.
Get out.
What about a beer?
Beat it!
Just let me sit here with an empty glass in front of me.
Out!
I demand to see the manager. Where's Maud?
I'm Maud. Charles F. Maud. And if you are not out of here in 1 minute, I'm going to take you by the scruff of the neck and throw you out.
All right, all right. I'm going. It's the last time I do my drinking in this place.
Double bourbon. Scotch on the side, no ice, and a cherry in it. Make that 2 cherries. And bring on the dancing boys. Alvarez is the name, but I want you to call me Spanish Rose. The bonnet.
Oh, Spanish Rose?
See?
Get out.
Now, wait a minute. You can't throw me out. I'm an American citizen, and it's my constitutional right
Maud.
To drink here.
Hello,
if
this
I
is Albert Peterson speaking.
And get loaded
is Miss Rose
here
Alvarez
if
there?
I so choose.
Who?
And do any manner
Miss
of violent trashy things here if
Rose
I so
here
choose.
Now.
This
Could
is Spanish Rose's
please?
Coming out party.
Hold
when
the
I say coming out,
hey,
I mean coming out.
Castro. I got a guy named Peterson here who says he wants to talk to you.
Tell that wheezy little rat I'm not here.
That proves that she's there. Who else would know I'm a wheezy little rat? Rose, I've got to talk to you. It's about Conrad.
And furthermore, if I were this Rose, which I'm not, the one thing that would certainly make me hang up is any mention of anybody named Conrad.
Rose, wait. Don't hang up. I won't mention Conrad. We can talk about anything you want. You, me, I, anything. Oh, Rosie, please.
Talk to me, baby, won't you talk to me? I don't care what you say, baby, talk to me. Must you be so far away from me? It seems all wrong this way. Talk to me. And if you miss me, tell me so. Are you lonely? Tell me so. Say you love me. Tell me so, honey, let me know. Talk to me till I press you close to me. Then you'll see we won't have to talk at all. I don't care what you say, talk to me. And if you miss me, are you lonely? Say you love me, tell me so. Till I press you close.
Rose, are you alone?
No, I'm not alone, Albert. I'm with friends. See you later, boys.
See you later, boys? Oh, Rose, you've got to help me find Conrad.
And that's only the beginning, Albert. From now on, the sky's the limit. Parties, balls, dances. Amapola, my pretty aunt. Hey, what's in there?
That's a private dining room.
Private for whom?
For men only, that's who.
Men only? That's exactly what I'm looking for. I've heard about what goes on in these small towns. Get out of Spanish Rose's way.
Hey, you can't let her in there. Spanish Rose, I'm on my way. Mama, get my coat.
Subject I'd like to bring up that I'm sure is on everybody's mind. That would definitely be...
Thank you.
Alvarez, I have a favor to ask of you. Could you go back in there and get me some grain alcohol to go?
Not for $1 million.
My whole world is collapsing before me. I can't get a drink, and Kim's gone off with Conrad to the ice house.
Kim and Conrad? Albert, I've got to phone Albert. Hugo, you stay right here. Wait a minute!
Mom's roadside retreat. I'm coming for you, Rosie. Mama, hurry up.
I don't know why we have to go running around all night looking for someone it would be better not to find in the first place. If you listen to me, Sonny, you'll come home. Have a nice cup of postum and go to bed.
Mama, I'm not going home until I find Rosie. Now, if you want to leave, that's all right with me. As a matter of fact, why don't you go home, Mama?
What did you say, sweetheart?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama?
Would you mind repeating that once more, sunshine of my existence?
Mama, go home. I don't need you anymore.
So it's come at last. At last it's come. The day I knew would come at last. It's come at last. My sunny boy doesn't need me any longer. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of me. Throw me out with the used grapefruits. Put me out with the empty cans of bumblebee salmon. Never mind putting a lid on. Leave it open. So 100,000 pussycats can walk all over your mother. Who brushed your baby shoes? Kissed every little bruise. Hit your dirty socks up off the floor. You cough, and who was there? It's just too hard to bear. A mother doesn't matter anymore. With bunions on my feet, I trudge through snow and sleet to bring you licorice from the corner store. I sold my Tiffany lamp so you could go to camp. Now a mother doesn't matter anymore. That's it. I'm ready to go. I don't want you to spend a cent, though. Fancy funerals are for rich people. Just wait till Mother's Day. Wrap me in a flag and dump me in the river. Precious, by the way, the doctor called today. But I got a condition, yes, he sure. There's nothing he can do. I'll last a week or two. Because for a condition, there's no cure. The time you caught the croup who made you chicken soup and read you Bambi till her throat was sore. You sacrifice your life. Then bang! You get the knife. No mother doesn't matter anymore. I'm better now. Everything is as it should be. A mother is lying on top of a sanitation truck bound for the city dump, and her son is running around in saloons with the Mexicali Rose, who came over for fruit picking season and stayed to ruin an American woman's life. Gave up nights of rest to rub Vicks on your chest, who nursed her sonny boy till he was born. My life is so in vain. This country's down the drain. Now a mother doesn't matter, no. A mother doesn't matter, yes. A mother doesn't matter anymore.
Are you finished, Mama?
Yes, sonny boy.
Good night, Mama.
You're just like your father. You'd marry anything. Good night, sonny boy.
My name is not Sonny Boy.
Good night, Albert. My sonny boy. Oh, Mama's little boy.
Mr. Peterson, have you seen Conrad and Pa there? Mr. McAfee.
Unfortunately, I must tell you, Conrad's affairs no longer interest me. Right now, I'm looking for Miss Alvarez to tell her that... Conrad and Kim?
They've run off together.
And if we don't find them soon, Mr. Peterson, I intend calling the FBI. Who's the head of it now, dear? Is it Peter Lawford yet? Oh, I'm sure everything's all right.
Donna Perry, have you seen Ursula? Is she missing too? I've looked everywhere and I can't find her.
Mr. Peterson.
You haven't seen my Harvey, have you? Or Roger?
Oh, Phyllis.
Now, I'm sure they're all safe. Maybe they're down at the drugstore. Maybe having one of those gang wars.
Gang wars?
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids, who can understand anything they say?
Kids, they're so ridiculous and so immature. I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and see.
Kids, they're just impossible to
soon
control.
You'll be old enough to be.
Kids with their awful clothes and their rock
another
and roll.
Another teenage delinquent.
Why can't they be like you? We're perfect in every way.
What's the matter with kids? Do kids? What the devil's wrong with these kids today? Kids, who could guess that they would turn out that way? Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids?
Hi, everybody. Good old Hugo here. Loop.
Oh, Hugo, what have you been drinking?
Milk. But it worked. Anyhow, I've got the perfect right to be drunk. My girls gone off with Conrad Barty to the...
To the movies! Great double bill tonight, flying down to Rio in Greed. What a cast! Dolores Del Rio
and Gene Raymond.
And what a score!
I'd forgotten.
Hey, Rio, flying down to Rio.
Rosie, I've got great news. I'm a new man, Rosie. I sent Mama home. I'm a world leader.
Conrad and Kim have gone to the ice house.
The ice house?
The ice house?
Doris, call the mounted police. Call Mr. Keene, tracer of lost persons. Call the Shadow. Look him up under Lamont Cranston.
Well, that was refreshing. Of course, I do prefer a Murad, but these will do. Well, Conrad, this is the ice house. Fun, isn't it? Of course, when you've been here as many times as I have, I've been here with just about everyone, you know. Ursula, Deborah Sue, the Girl Scouts. Stronger than the chocolate ones, aren't they? Conrad, you seem a little bit nervous. Maybe a drag on this weed will relax you. Or, how about one of those reefers I've heard so much about? I can go out and get you a fix if you tell me what it is. You know, when you've had a donkey on your back as long as I have. Conrad, you're trembling. Just because I'm a few years older than you are, I hope it doesn't make you uncomfortable. I'm 27 or 28, you know, one of the two. So you see, I really know the score. I even know some of the words. Canubian, premarital, jailbait.
We've been looking for you everywhere.
That's nice. Now, out of my way. I'm late.
But wait, you don't understand. We're coming with you. You said it yourself. We got a lot of living to do.
Now, wait a minute.
We'll never go home again. We'll follow you to the ends of the earth.
For my twin, firebomb racing. Loop the loop.
Yeah!
Of course, that stuff really ain't as much fun as I made it out to be.
We can start right now. Let's have an orgy.
No!
That's a lot of living! What's going on here? Conrad? Conrad? There he is, that depraved brute. Arrest that man. What do you have to say for yourself, Mr. Birdie?
Thank God you've come.
Hi, everybody.
Hugo
again.
Oh, Hugo, darling. You're just in time. I can't tell you what humiliation I've been made to suffer.
That's all I need to hear. Take him away. Mr. McAfee, I demand you release that boy. Mr. McAfee! Mr. McAfee, do you hear me? Mr. McAfee!
Albert!
My ideas.
No use. Look, why don't you go back to the house and I'll go down to the courthouse and try talking to the mayor.
Rose, maybe you didn't understand me before. This is the new Albert.
But Albert...
Don't let Albert me, Rose. You are merely woman. I am man.
woman's job is to obey, keep the house clean, and speak only when she is spake to. And my first command, woman, is for you to get your bags and to be down at the station tomorrow morning at 6:30 when I intend to be there with Conrad. And I further command you to bring whatever documents are necessary because I intend to make you Mrs. Albert Peterson by 2400 hours tomorrow. Roger, over and out. Rose, did I mention I loved you?
Not yet, Albert.
Well, I do. Conrad!
It's going to be such a wonderful life. I'm going to be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson. Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now.
Hello, Rose.
Hello, May.
Have you a minute to spare? For a heart to heart with an old friend.
I'll always have time to talk to the woman who by tomorrow evening I'll be able to call.
Don't say it, Rose.
I'll be able to call Mother.
The cruelest word I've ever heard. To think I would live to see the day and have relatives in El Salvador.
Not to mention Guatemala, Brazil, Chile, Uruguay, and Chichicastenango. And once Albert and I are married, I'm going to stick a rose in my teeth, sit in front of my adobe hut on Central Park West, and sell tortilla. Adios, mama.
Adios, Rosita.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Oh!
I'm just a Spanish tamale according to May. Right off the boat from the tropics far, far away. Which is kind of funny, since where I come from is Imperial PA. Spanish! Okay, May, I'll be Spanish. Right after I've married Alberto, I'll be the toast of Chichicastenango, and all day long my castanets will click. I'll hide behind my fan and do the tango. I'll be so Spanish it will make you sick. I'll eat the taco and the enchilada. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain. The only song I'll sing will be Granada. I'll be more Espanol than Abby Lane.
Go, go, go!
La cuca! Racha! So call me the wild Spanish rose, the craziest flower that grows. I'll kick up my heels and see how it feels to be a sultry Spanish rose. Behind my mantilla I'll pose the beauty that nobody knows. So regal and cool, exciting and cruel, that's me, Spanish Rose. Mi Nerotito Hernandez. You buy my tortilla? You like me? Yes, no, maybe, yes. Americana, let me give you a bit of advice. Cross Spanish rose isn't wise. The match you have found, so don't mess around. Her heart, she is cold like ice. With Albert, I will dance to the bolero. We'll cha-cha in the nicest honky-tonks. He'll wear the cutest moustache and sombrero. My handsome Latin lover from the Bronx. So, now that you've met Spanish rose, you'll never forget Spanish Rose. She'll taunt you, she'll tame you, but what man would blame you for worshiping Spanish Rose? Not Danish, not British, not Swedish, not Yiddish, but Spanish.
Come on. There's nobody here.
Now,
come
wait
on.
A minute. Wait a minute.
Shut up and get on that train. It took every cent I had to bail you out. And I don't want us to eat. We're out of the state.
Now, look here, buddy boy. Whether you pay me no guarantee or not, you got a contract with me forever.
Conrad, what are you saying?
Here's a piece of paper. I signed my name to it. Just fill in whatever you want.
Hello, Albert.
Ooh, Mama!
Rose! You look good for a change. Don't worry. I know all about you two. I won't make a fuss. I'll do what any intelligent mother must do. Goodbye, dear. And don't worry about the coat. Oh, you'll have 3 weeks' stalls after the train passes over me.
Mama, get up and get on that train. I don't have any time for your nonsense.
Just a moment, Mr. Peterson. I demand to know what you've done with Conrad. He's not in that jail.
Well, how should I know where he is? I haven't seen him all night. I'm just here to say goodbye to Rosie. Mr. Peterson.
Now, dear, there's no point in getting upset. There was no real harm done. Hugo and Kim are back together again, and as a matter of fact, the sweetest thing happened. He proposed to her this morning, and she accepted him.
Oh.
Oh, dear, what's wrong?
My life is over now. I'll sell the house and go into a home. All aboard!
Albert.
Albert.
Albert!
Albert, don't leave me.
Bye,
Albert!
Conrad.
Come back, son. Albert.
Well, here I am, Albert. 6:30 on the button. Where's the train?
Left at 6:25.
But Albert, you told me to be here.
With Conrad.
At 6:30 sharp. I know.
And Mama.
Albert, you wanted us to miss that train.
Stands to reason, Rose. Why get on the train to New York? Well, we've got tickets to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa.
What's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff of the Pumpkin Falls Junior High School. Read about in this morning's paper. They need someone to teach domestic science and English. And I hope you brought your documents, Rose, because I prefer the applicant to be married.
Albert.
Rosie. Did anyone ever tell you it's the most beautiful name in the world?
I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I'd feel was several hours older. Lilacs or lilies, any bloom you please, all that they did was make me shrug or sneeze. But now I love each blossom that I see, for a lovely little rose loves me. Now my life is rosy, since I found my Rosie. With a girl like Rosie, how could I be blue? Hand in hand we'll mosey, me and little Rosie. We'll be so cozy by a fire built for two. Oh, I once heard a poem that goes, a rose is a rose is a rose. Well, I don't agree, take it from me. There's one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my Rosie. I'm so glad you chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me.
Thank you.
now my life is rosy.
Oh, we'll be happy, I know.
With a girl like Rosie.
Off to the picture we'll go.
With a girl like Rosie.
Oh, how could we be?
How could I be blue?
Oh, we'll have us a home out west. Nice little split level nest. And in every room, roses in bloom.
But there's one rose sweeter than all of the rest. That's my rose.
I'm so glad you chose me.
Life is one sweet, beautiful song. Love is right.
Then what could be wrong?
Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me.
Kids, you gotta love us.